This is the mid sagittal section of the head and neck region, showing the right and the left mid sagittal section along with the section of the along with the specimen of the larynx. In this specimen you can clearly see the nasal cavity. Behind the nasal cavity lies the nasopharynx. This is oral cavity, and behind the oral cavity you can see the oropharynx. This is the larynx, and behind the larynx you can see the laryngopharynx. This is the nasal cavity, and within the nasal cavity you can clearly see the bony projections, and these bony projections are called as the conchas. And here lies the superior concha, middle concha, and the inferior concha. And between these concha there lies the spaces which are called as the meatus, and the meatus that is meant for the opening of the paranasal air sinuses. This is inferior concha, and below to the inferior concha there is an opening of the nasolacrimal duct. This is middle meatus, and in the middle meatus there is an opening of the frontal air sinus along with the maxillary, and the anterior and middle ethmoidal sinus, and the posterior ethmoidal sinus which will open up into the superior meatus along with the sphenoidal air sinuses. This is the nasal cavity, and behind the nasal cavity lies the nasopharynx. And in this structure you can clearly see there is an opening. This opening is the pharyngotympanic tube or the Eustachian tube, which is connecting the middle ear cavity or the tympanic cavity with the nasopharynx. And just behind to the opening of this cavity or the Eustachian tube, you can see there is a slight elevation. These are the tubal tonsils. And behind the this space you can see there is a recess. This recess is called as the fossa of Rosenmüller. In between the nasal cavity and the oral cavity lies the hard palate. You can clearly see this is hard palate, and behind the hard palate lies the soft palate. This is nasal cavity and this is oral cavity, and in the oral cavity you can see this is tongue and the intrinsic muscles of the tongue. And behind the tongue you can see some of the arches. This is palatoglossus arch that is running from the palate to the tongue. This is palatoglossus, and this is palatopharyngeus. And in between the palatoglossus and the palatopharyngeus you can see this there lies the palatine tonsil, which lies within the palatine fossa. And this is the epiglottis. This is structure. This is the epiglottis, and this is the continuation of the larynx, which continues downward as in trachea.